we do this event?
Yes, tell us, first of all, your name and your involvement with Windermere Tree.
My name is Teresa Schressman Myers, and I'm the chairman of the Windermere Tree Board. And myself and my committee, Joan Foglia, Susan Carter, Frank Prince, Jackie McCore, we put on the Windermere Tribute every year on Arbor Day. In Florida, we plant our trees the third weekend in January because it's too hot in April, the last of the 48 states. So your trees have the best chance of survival if you plant them now in January because they don't stress out from the heat. And we've been doing this festival for 13 years. We partner with the arborists who come in, and in exchange for pruning our trees here and in the Central Park, where they train and teach safety training and safety climbing, we host this festival together. They do the kids' tree climb. Competition. They come in from 48 states, Canada, Great Britain, to climb the trees. They're all over in Central Park. And if you walk through there, you'll see them over there. And then we do safety training in Town Hall as well on Thursday and Friday before the tribute. But today's event was all about Windermere folks coming to pick out their Arbor Day tree and planting it in the ground so that we can replace our aging tree canopy and keep our urban forest healthy.
And that's why Windermere, Florida.
Yes, and we're Tree City USA. This will be our 24th year as a Tree City USA.
Do you have to have in order to be a Tree City?
You have to have a tree ordinance, number one, to protect your trees. Number two, you have to host an Arbor Day festival so that people understand the significance and importance of trees and what they do for your town, for your ecosystem, for your health. We couldn't survive without trees. They give us oxygen. They sequester carbon, tons of carbon that we put out on the planet. The trees and the ocean take care of that.
Recently, I've been hearing a lot more people, and I travel to other cities.
Right.
Dry cough. Those are all signs of not.
So they're giant carbon sequestration machines, and that's how trees get their mass. Is they take in our carbon dioxide, and they make their mass off of that air, and then they take the rest, the sunlight and the rain and the trace elements. That's a little maybe 2 to 5%. So most of them are made from carbon. They're giant carbon sequestration machines. They also give us shade. They give us food. They give us fruit.
And it helps to decrease crime rate.
Yes, they do.
In cities where there are more trees, they have less crime.
They also protect our chain of lakes in Windermere. They control all the stormwater runoff through stormwater runoff mitigation. They give us protect us from heat, from the heat island effect because of the beautiful shade. It'll be 15 degrees cooler under a tree on a street like this versus no trees. They give us habitat for our beautiful birds that we take for granted in Windermere, our hawks, our raptors, our owls, all of our wildlife that migrate through the chain of lakes. There's a huge migratory route here through Windermere because of our tree urban forest and our tree canopy. So they give us food, wood to build our houses, clothing, shelter, fruit, habitat. There's just so many things trees do for us that we couldn't survive without them on the planet. So it's really important that you replace the trees.
Folks, in just a minute.
Plant your Arbor Day tree.
We're going to announce
last year, somebody was actually also giving me help on feverishly weeding and protect our trees.
Yes, and if you have a tree in your yard, don't use Weed and Feed. Just use the fertilizer because the herbicide in the Weed and Feed is very detrimental to your tree, and some of them could even kill your tree. So just stick with a basic fertilizer. Forget the herbicide. They damage your trees. Grass and trees are not
to mention Parkinson's.
Yes, they're very toxic too. Any of your herbicides, you share about 82% of your DNA with bugs. So if it's going to kill a bug, it's going to affect your body and your DNA too. So you have to be careful when you're using herbicides and pesticides. They do genetic damage. They prove that bisphosphate does cause cancer. So you have to be very careful when you're using any kind of the Roundup or any kind of the herbicides.
Thank you for hosting that event.
Super
really
careful. You can kill weeds just using straight vinegar.
Yes.
Purely organic. Straight vinegar will do the same weed kill that you need to do without the toxicity to you or any kind of carcinogenic, cancer-causing agents. So there's other ways of doing things.
Well, thank you all for hosting this event every year.
You're welcome.
Yeah, we all appreciate it.
Did you enjoy the event today?
Yes. Thank you.